Hello there, welcome back to Lunar, or Let's Play Lunar. Eternal Blue, blind. I'm the RPG chick. Oh, right, some stuff happened. I kind of dislike that this happened, but... Well, I definitely dislike what happened at the end of the last episode. We all died, which forced me to return to my previous save state, which was unfortunately made before we fought the Plantella creature. Now, as you recall, at the end of the episode before last, which I guess is... Let me see. We're on 16 now, so it was at the end of 14, which was a two-part episode, so part one of two, end of 14. We were all basically gone, dead, unconscious, whatever you... I guess we're unconscious at this point because we come back after the fight's over, generally speaking. So, always happen. Anyway, I'm rambling. Ronfar saved the day with the last round that would have been. Unfortunately, after that we wandered around here and got killed by those creatures. In part because all the levels went to him. Now, interesting enough, we had to fight the Plantella creature over again. This time, consider this, and that was an alternate reality, and this is our reality now. Instead of all the levels going to Ronfar, which is like three levels, I believe, if I remember correctly, they got split among us. So, what's interesting is that as I saw, at the end of fighting the Plantella creature, this time off camera, we all survived. The experience points was, of course, scattered among us like they should have been. Hero went up a level. Ronfar went up a level. I believe Jean went up two levels. And I think Jean just went up again. I was up by that waterfall area, up, northeast of here. I was wandering around a little bit. I saw she almost had enough to level, so right before I started recording this, I leveled her up, so she's actually gained three levels now. So she's 10. Ronfar went up two, I believe, and Hero went up once. So what's interesting is since Ronfar was the one left, he was the only one left standing. He got all the experience points, which made him go up three levels. So those experience points are still used. They're pumped into whatever character's still alive. Character or characters. So I find that to be an interesting mechanic. I wasn't sure if it would be that way, but it is. So we're a little more evened out. I'm kind of bummed. It's better this way. It's gonna be easier this way. Because we're not behind in levels. Especially Jean has caught up to Hero now. Rather than Ronfar having so many freaking levels. He was up to level 14, I believe. If I remember right. But that was such a kick-ass battle. The way that ended. It's sad. It's no longer... It's wiped. It's no longer part of the game. So, at least I got it on camera, so to speak. So anyway, here we are, and as far as Hero, he has this Sibilum sword, which is a split spirit attack. You'll see this soon enough whenever he fights something again. He basically splits into two heroes and attacks the enemy flanks from both sides and attacks both of them attack. And Ronfar, I was actually able to level up his change dice ability. So how he has this risk roulette. Attack same party. I don't know what that means. I don't want him to attack us. So I guess we'll have to mess around with that. And, what's her name doesn't have anything new. Jean doesn't have any new abilities. Uh, Basically, I think it's if the dance, chance, health, whatever, wind are white, if the word is white, we can level it up. So we can't level any of those up. So anyway, let's check this out. Oh, this sounds rather spooky. Go that way. Ruby says, this door is not going to budge. I don't think we're getting in here, hero. Okay. Look at that. There's another entrance or exit up over there. But I can't go over there. So I guess we're going next door. Oh good, we can heal up here. Let me just get a drink of fine ginger ale. Mmm. Good for what ails ya. Mmm. Seagram's brand. I actually like Seagram's brand. I don't like shrub so much. Canada Dry is still my favorite. But nice and cold with ice cubes and a little bit watered down. Perfect. Welcome to Takkar. This is a resting point for all the tradesmen in the area. They come here to rest up and trade stories of the road. I should warn you about the house to the east. The ghost manor is rumored to be haunted by a terrible force. Yeah, we couldn't get in there. Ruby says, ghost? Hero, let's steer clear of that, place, okay? Hello. There's a hooded figure lurking about town. You better not talk to it. If you do accidentally, come to me. Accidentally? What are you gonna do to help? I failed a trial at the Ghost Manor because I was not good with magic. Those flying girls are impossible. I couldn't even scratch them. Flying girls? A strange girl who called herself the Premier of the Magic Guild was just here. I don't know what she could possibly want around here. Twins? Say there, strangers. Have you decided on a place to stay while you're here? Tell you what, I'll make you a great deal on a room. It's only 10 silver. And best of all, breakfast is included. That's okay, we already healed up at the statue. All the best-looking women stay at my motel. Why don't you stay there, too? Grandfather says, hey, chief, this sounds like a pretty sweet deal. 10 silver per night, free breakfast, and curvy scenery that's easy on the eyes. Ruby says, whoa there, Ronfar. Rein in the stallion. You've got work to do. Hello? Please have mercy on me, for I have no magic ability. Ruby says, what the heck's wrong with this bozo? It seems like he's afraid of something. My son is such a stupid boy. He falls for a strange magic girl, and now look at him. Oh, sorry, I thought you were twins. We went into the haunted manor to try and impress her. Idiot. new travelers. You poor, poor souls. Poor souls? Ruby asks. What is he talking about? Well, let's take a look around in these houses here. Oh, there's a little kid or something. You know what? Huh? I met the Premier of the Magic Guild of Vane. When I grow up, I want to be in the Magic Guild. But it costs a lot, so I'm going to start saving my money right now. When I get bigger, I'm going to join the Magic Guild. Okay, who's in here? Hello. Ever since the gate was closed, my inn has been packed. We have the lowest priced rooms in town, and since no one can pass the gate, they just stay here and wait till this monster situation out. Anything to look at here? Look like a chest, doesn't it? Harold, you told me that this trip would be an exciting affair. I'm nothing but tired and bored. Sitting in this lousy hotel isn't helping. Harold, are you listening to me? Harold! Harold? Now that the gate is closed, my wife and I can't get on with our trip. I was planning on taking her to the carnival, but now, I don't know. Can't believe my rotten luck. My wife's complaining is driving me crazy. Small hotel. Hello, hello. Welcome to the Bounteous Babe Inn. We're here to serve your every need. Sorry, Lucia? Lucia says, but their faces are the same. I've never seen anything like it. Ruby says, we call that twins. My sister and I started this inn when we noticed all the travelers in town. Since most of them were merchants, we knew a name like Bounteous Babe would get their attention. So what do you say? Want to give our inn a try? Ranfrost says, well, Sugar Plum, that's the closest thing to a direct invite I could hope for. What do you say, Chief? Let's check it out. This is the most popular inn in the village. Sometimes even villagers stay here. Kinda like the song. It's pretty bouncy. Whenever my business takes me near this town, I always stay here. This place is stocked with the most gorgeous women. Talk about eye candy. Woo-wee. Ruby says, yeah, but in your place, it's like P-U. Your eyes are more like eye sewage. Your looks are more like eye sewage. Hello? Even though I live in this village, I stay here at the inn sometimes. I'm hoping one of the women will notice and ask me out. You usually have to make the move, guy. Just gonna stay here and hope they ask you out. That won't get you anywhere. Well, I don't know if there's an option to actually stay here. These aren't doors, right? No. Was that the hooded guy? Let's not talk to him yet. Can I go in there? I can't go in there. Hick! Those stupid idiots closed the gate! Just for a hick monster? This is costing me plenty in lost trade. Hick. Howdy, barkeep. The Althena cult is making a business out of the fear of these monsters. I don't know how the goddess can allow them to do that. Jean says, I'm sure she won't allow it for long. What? Kevin Bacon, what? The cult leaders are getting to be real sticklers. Now they say that alcohol, song, and dance are off-limits to followers. Kevin Bacon, where are you when we need you? I'm not sure what he has to do with anything. Hi, we're just going to look around back here. There's nothing to interact with. How sad. It's my job to transport goods from Nota to Dalton. I always like to stop in at this bar for a little R&R before I continue. Now that the gates have been closed, our business is going to die out. I sure in the hope they get those monsters killed in a hurry, or we're in big trouble. Say there, strangers. I haven't seen you in here before. Where are you from? Nota? Dalton? Larpa? My name is Lucia. I have come from the Blue Star. Well then, you've come mighty far. Perhaps you'd like some Dutch apple pie? Ranfrost says, hehe. The girl's just having some fun with you. Actually, we're from Larpa. We're on a group tour of the area. We'll be seeing you. You know, your talk about the Blue Star reminded me of a legend I heard about it. They said that long ago, our ancestors came from the Blue Star, courtesy of Althena. Don't know if it's true, but it's a mighty romantic notion. Lucius says, what you speak is not legend, but history. It really happened long ago. Now, how in the world would you know that? Oh, I get it. You're pulling my leg again. Haha, good one. You got me. Can I open this? Can we do anything else? Why is there a door if I can't even use it? Okay. I'll go visit the hooded man last. Because I have a feeling that will be a pretty pivotal event. Perhaps. We gotta buy some starlights if possible. Can I go back here? Is this a sign we can read? Nope. Hello, just gonna invade your bedroom and stuff. Nope. Nothing good. Hi. If you've come looking for potions, lotions, or herbs, or emotion, this is the place. So now, what would you like to do? I can buy emotion. Can I buy some joy? I'd like to buy joy. Oh, they have purity herb, spring water. Two spring waters. I think we have enough herb for a while. Thank you, thank you. Come again. Thanks for that herb, y'all. Woo. I don't want to go in there. No. Sorry, guys. Can I read the sign? Nope. Did we talk to you? Yeah. Better be careful. I just heard there's strange monsters roaming about, and a hooded figure has been seen around town. Beware the Moors. That's what I say. Is that a reference? Sounds familiar. Weapons shop. Weapons and armor. Can I go through here? Ah, have you come to upgrade your armor? That's not a bad idea these days. What with all the monsters running around mauling innocent folk? So tell me, what can I do for you? Can I sell this peasant clothes? Now, what you selling? Leather armor. I think the people who are moving, I don't know. Wisdom of 1,000, okay. Really? Okay, well, as far as scale armor, already better than that. Let's see, because I'm not sure if I understand this. Can I buy it for... K... Can't be equipped. Can't. Okay, never mind. Huh. A wisdom robe is actually better than, what do you call it? Iron armor? His defense goes up by 2 and his wisdom goes up by 3. Yeah, sold. Buy and equip. It's been a pleasure serving you today. Stop by again soon. I don't know if... Wait, who's wearing it? Oh, Ronfar is wearing it, never mind. So it's better than scale. I think if I go into equip, it tells you. Yeah, defense, how it goes down like that. I'm gonna hold on to the scale for now. Welcome, come in, come in. What can I do for you fine folks today? Can I sell the ancient knife? Do I need it? Hope not, because I sold it. Okay, let's see what they got for sale. A short sword, we got a long sword. We got a mace for Ronfar. We got a feather fan, which I think she already has. A water staff, which nobody can use. Maybe the hooded figure, who will join us, I suppose. A bow. Attack power plus 50. Distance attack. Better off to give him the bow. Unfortunately, he loses an attack, but wow, it goes up in power. Basically, one attack in two. I mean, two attacks in one. He only has to attack once. Buy and equip. As far as the water staff, no one can use it yet. Let's get the long sword for, I was gonna say Alex, hero. Definitely having a much easier time getting new weapons. I found very early on in the first game that the first Lunar game that I just couldn't afford stuff. A little easier here. Anyway. Standard dialogue. How do you like that? Okay, we gotta sell this dagger. I don't think whoever comes in the party next is gonna have something less than a dagger. But in any case, they're pretty cheap, so I'll just sell this dagger. And short sword I'll just hold on to for now. You know what? I'll take a chance and sell it. So yeah, we're gonna sell that stuff. Oh, I didn't look. Hold on a second. Bear with me, guys. Sorry. Yes, it's just attack power. Goes down. You should still attack twice around. Okay. Hello again. Sorry. Just looking at stuff. Well, I'm not buying anything. Sorry. I'm gonna sell something to you. Sell the short sword. And save this dagger. Thank you. I like the buy and equip, it's pretty cool. What's in here? Wish I could look at more things. Hi. Say, you look like you're new to this town. At least you picked a good inn. I'm a traveling merchant. Do you want to see any of my wares? Lucia says, merchant? Wares? I don't understand the meaning of those words. Ruby says, if you remain ignorant of those terms and credit cardless, you'll be every man's fantasy, mate. Someday I'm going to be the most successful merchant in all history. So there's three inns in this little town. Interesting. Aye. Many people come here because they like the town's atmosphere. Once, long ago, I came to this town and liked it so much I set up this inn. Best decision I ever made. I mean, it's just a tiny bed and breakfast inn, but it's my dream, and I'm living it. Hmm. I said I'm living it. Hmm. You talk to him yet? Oh yeah. Fearsome monsters have been coming into the village lately. That's why we sealed the north gate. If we don't open the gate, they can't get in anymore. Hold on a second, guy. The only problem is that the north gate leads the way to Nota. And until the monsters are defeated, we're cut off. Can I go up? Oh, that's one of the temples. Just have to talk to that guy over there. Did I? Yeah, I've been here. Hello? Welcome to Takkar. Make a donation and pray for safe travel, won't you? If you do not, grave things could happen to you. What a sweetie. There has been much commotion in the village lately. Villagers are afraid of all the monsters that have come to our village. But we of the Althena cult will destroy the monsters using Althena's power. If donations increase, Lord Leo will come and slay the monsters. Now then, will you donate? The world is safest under the watch of Althena's cult members. The sooner you realize this, the better it will be for you. Isn't this shrine the most beautiful place you've ever seen? If you want a long life and much happiness, donate to the goddess Althena. In my former life, I was a tradesman, but then I felt the calling. Now I am a servant of the cult of Althena. Donation, please. When I quit my former life, I gave all my assets to the Althena cult. I live now only to collect more donations for Althena. You live only for that? How sad. We are trying our best to spread the word of Althina, but there are many that still want to sing, dance, and make money instead. Jean says, but I thought Althina loved singing and dancing. Many of the villagers don't believe what we tell them of Goddess Althina. Someday the goddess will come and punish them for their ignorance. Yeah. I guess that's it. I'm not missing anything, right? Usually there's like other areas or something around, or different... the different exits? No? Okay. Anything we can do anything with? No. Alright, let's get out of here. Can't go that way. Hey there, travelers. I'm afraid I can't let you pass this gate. There's been reports of monsters in the cave, so we've sealed it. As a priest of Althina, I cannot let you pass in good conscience. Conscience. It's sealed until the monster situation is resolved. Ronfor says, come on. This is the only road that leads to Nota and, ultimately, Pentagulia. You gotta let us pass, buddy. Hey, buddy. Well, he's not gonna let us pass, buddy. Okay, let's go talk to the hooded man. Welcome, travelers. I am a messenger from the Magic Guild of Vayne. We are recruiting new members. Excellent, I remember Vayne. Would you like to join the guild? There's only a simple test and an entrance fee. Ruby says, hey, hero, that sounds like fun. Why don't we take the test? Oh, poo. I forgot to tell you that we don't allow flying cats. I always forget that. Well, then, that's still okay since I'm not a cat. But you look like a cat with... Ronfor says, hey sister, hate to break up the raging kitty debate, but we've got to get moving. We don't have time to take your test. Ah yes, but you cannot pass the gate to continue your quest anyway. Haven't you heard? The gate is sealed because of terrible monster attacks. Jean says, then we'll tell the guard we can kill the monsters if he opens the gate. Perhaps that plan will work, or maybe it won't. You can only try. In any event, I'll be around. Ruby says, whew, talk about your hood fetish, Kooks. That girl was a mountain of weird. I mean, offering us a test to enter the Magic Guild and then excluding me? Like, what kind of attitude is that? Give me a break. Can we now go through this door? I don't know what this door is. We can't go through there. Ronfor says, but we can defeat the beasts if you just let us through. I'm sorry, I don't have the authority to make that decision. Besides, I have already sent for Lord Leo. He'll take care of this in no time. Just be patient. He should be here soon. No, he'll find Lucia. Ruby says, if Leo's coming, we better lay low. Here comes hooded figure. You're wasting your time with that fool. Come with me, and I'll share something very interesting. You will, huh? If you have enough magic power, you can bypass this gate. There's a haunted manor to the east of the village with a secret mountain pass. If you can get through the manor, the pass will take you to Nota. I'll be waiting outside the manor. Don't keep me waiting. Huh. Ruby says, didn't she say the manor was haunted? Maybe she was one of the spooks. Lucia says, I sense that she had an aura of strong magic about her. Jean says, maybe we should take her advice and check it out. Oh, this is just great. Some weird girl comes out of nowhere, and we're going to take her advice and follow her through some spook house. This is just going to make my week. Not too long ago, I believed what the girl said and took her test. It was a nerve-shattering experience that I don't care to relive. I still have nightmares about it to this day. To add insult to injury, she took money from me as a test fee. Say, have you decided to stay at the Bounteous Babe Hotel? No, we've got work to do. Maybe some other time. Okay, I'm gonna call in an episode here. I'm gonna, next episode, we're gonna see if what are the new things the villagers have to say, and then we're gonna head over to the Spook Manor, so to speak. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.